Hi friends, welcome back to Pictures and Paintings.
To make any painting look believable, the underlying pencil sketching stage plays a very key role. So I would like to start this video by breaking down my technique. I adopt a three-step process while I sketch my pictures. My first step is to quickly block the rough sketch of the characters. In this stage, I try to understand whether the spacing around the characters are working, whether it is placed in the right spot that where I wanted it to be, and how much of environmental details is going to be coming. Once the rough shape is blocked, the next step is to get the proportions right. Here again, I limit to the external form, mainly to see whether the thick, thin areas are captured well, like the trunk, whether the tapering of the trunk is accurate, and whether the shape of the legs are not looking inorganic and things like that. Once the outer proportions are working well, then I get into penciling the details. While it is not really needed to pencil in all the details, one big advantage I find with doing it during pencil sketching stages, particularly if you are referring to a photograph, then the biggest question is, how much of that information in the photograph are we going to carry forward in our painting? Like in this case, where the elephant had a lot of wrinkles in the skin. So the big decision for me was to decide which one of those I am going to carry forward from my reference photograph and which ones I am going to compromise on. Because obviously painting each and every one of them is impossible. And I also did not want to go to that level. So the advantage of making the decision in the pencil sketching stage is that it allowed me to try out a few variants. So I used to draw a couple of lines, and then if I felt that it is becoming too complex, then I would erase it off. And similarly, if I find a portion where the level of detail was very low compared to the trunks, which is my centerpiece and the center of attention, I added a little bit more details. So I have been adapting this style quite a bit, and it has worked out really well. After the pencil sketch was done, I masked off a few areas where I felt the highlights would be coming, and where I wanted to preserve the white, and started my painting with a very, very subtle wash of the shadow region. Once the base wash of the elephants were done, I painted an equally pale wash of the background. I did this at this stage to ensure the horizon lines were working and the color combinations were integrating well. My base wash of the background was more of a wet on wet technique, where I liberally applied a pass of water first and used wet paint. This also creates a lot of natural variation, which gives the painterly look to our picture. This again is a technique which I am using more and more. I do a wet on wet base wash, and then as I start building the layers on top, it becomes more of wet paint on dry paper. The average lifespan of elephants is from 50 to 70 years. They are highly social animals with incredible memory. And we have heard a lot of stories, and in fact it is true. Elephants never forget. They are also known to display complex behavior, indicating that they feel empathy for others and are capable of demonstrating emotions, including grief. When we think of elephants, its a unique body always appeals to us, and the image of the trunk being used to suck water and spray always comes in front of our eyes. But other than that, they also use it for various different purposes. The elephant trunk is by far the most versatile appendage on the planet. It is used to breathe, drink, eat, smell, snorkel, communicate, as well as being used as a hand to touch, feel, hold, grab and pull. The trunks of elephants are extremely delicate, but are extremely strong. The African elephant has two finger-like tips at the end of their trunk, and it is used to clasp smaller objects. That's how they are able to hold and lift things. The trunk is so delicate, it is at times used to wipe or clean their eyes. On the other hand, the trunk is also extremely powerful tool that can pull out trees and lift up to 350 kgs or so. Interesting, right? With the base wash done, I started adding the details, and I started this with the trunk because I was quite clear even as I started painting that the trunks and face of both the elephants are going to be the ones which is going to be taking the attention. So I wanted to keep the maximum details here and then keep everywhere else relatively lesser. Did you know the elephant's tusks never stop growing? So enormous tusks can be a sign of an old elephant. And both male and female African elephants grow tusks. Unlike the Asian elephant subspecies, where only the male grow tusks, they not only use their trunk for breathing, smelling, drinking, and feeding, it is also used for social purposes like greetings and caressing. This is where I found this reference picture really emotive, where both the elephants seem to use their trunk to comfort each other. It was interesting to read that elephants may use their trunk to touch their face, mouth, ear, tusk, apparently to reassure and in an effort to make themselves feel better. Interesting, right? So once the details on the first elephant was completed, I did a similar one with the second one. This is where I could see the big advantage of adding the details during the pencil sketching stage. So I did not have to think much. Since I knew that those lines are already working, I had to just follow those lines and keep adding details. The only thing I had to consciously do is to ensure I keep softening the edges a little bit so that all lines don't look too hard. At this stage, I was pretty happy with how the elephants were turning out. While it looks complex from the outside, in reality, it wasn't that complicated. All I had to do was to ensure when I painted the base wash, I left the shadow regions a little bit more darker than the bright highlighted regions, and then just add the details over my pencil sketch. All the time investment which we had done during the pencil sketching stage ensured I did not face much hiccups during painting. So the first step is to just draw a quick sketch, a quick outline, to see if the placement of the character within the page is working out. And the second step is to get the proportion of the character right. And once the proportion is working, the third step is to explore the finer details that we would be going and painting in the painting stage and making a decision on what we are going to be compromising. And also the other benefit I am finding with this is since we are exploring the details on the character quite intricately, we start observing details which we normally might not observe. And that comes in very, very handy when we get into the painting stage. To add more element of interest, on the top portion of the second elephant, I copied the texture pattern which was there in the reference image. So if you look at both the elephants, they pretty much had a very similar structure to them. Plain, simple base washes, and then a straight line with wrinkled details. So these round patterns on the back of the second elephant is the relief which I wanted to give to those patterns, just to break the lines and create a little bit of inorganic look to the animals. I also consciously ensured in certain portions to give it a little bit of diffused look. The lines are not very well defined so that it blends with the background, which is very, very minimal in details. And once the details on both the elephants were added, it was already coming to life. And all I had to do was ensure I get in and darken the shadow regions even more. So I did two, three more coats on those places, and left the brighter regions with just the preliminary base washes. Once the elephants were looking good, I started adding details on the background. I copied the foreground elements from the reference image as it is. It had white rocks like the salt sediment from the lakes, and wet mud around it. And painting these were not very challenging. Another interesting fact which many people might not know is that to supplement the diet, elephants will dig up earth to obtain salt and minerals. They actually use their tusks to churn the ground. The elephant then places the dislodged piece of soil into their mouth to obtain the required nutrients. Salt is a necessary part of the elephant's diet. They are generally found in hotter climates, and the salt aids in retaining water. I consciously ensured the foreground had a similar level of detail like the elephant itself. Otherwise, having a highly detailed element on a very, very simple foreground will give it away. It might look like a cutout placed on top of a paper. So I ensured the ground just around the elephants had the same level of detail. And the backgrounds were already working. So I just left them as it is. I did not do much after the initial pause. And there you go. The painting is completed.
Hope you liked that video. Elephants are majestic creatures, and I am so lucky to have come across a good reference picture of these African elephants from which I could paint them from. When I started this painting, I was super excited from two accounts. One, I have been painting the wild animals in small A4 sized papers, and this image was the first one which I started painting on slightly bigger sheets. And the second interesting thing was, while the reference picture was so good, I did not find the background very appealing. So I decided to change the horizon line a bit and then show a lot of sky to give it a more open environment feel. And that too worked out really well in the final completed painting. If you like it, go for it, give it a shot, and don't forget to share your painting with me. I will be super excited to see that. Thank you for watching this till the end. See you soon in the next one. Until then, bye bye.